Oh my god. There's a cricket. There's a cricket. There's a cricket. Cricket. There's a cricket. Welcome back to Record Rant. I'm Serena Laurel, and I'm here with Justin Tanushi.
Hey, guys.
And we're here to talk about the new Bleachers album, Gone Now.
So, if you guys aren't familiar with Bleachers or Jack Antonoff, he was previously the lead guitarist for the band Fun. Strange Desire was the first record, and Gone Now is his sophomore album. It's very apparent Jack Antonoff is not going to run out of hooks anytime soon. That's for sure. It's funny because we have two different opinions on the album. I didn't like it nearly as much as Serena did. This album has a lot of different elements to it. It had big co-writers and other producers. Jack is a producer just as much as he is a songwriter, a guitarist. He kind of does it all.
He's worked with Taylor Swift and Lorde and Carly Rae Jepsen and all these huge people, and he's kind of gathered his songwriting name for himself.
Seeing the writing process and just listening to how he wrote a bunch of these songs and just taking into account his name in the music industry as a producer is really interesting. I feel like a lot of the topics in the songs aren't topics that are necessarily his heart and soul. It's his heart and soul trying to fit into how everyone else would understand it.
I don't think so. I think everything that he's talking about derived from a feeling that he was having himself that might have been relatable to everyone in their own way. The same reason why I, as a songwriter, write songs, but it might sound different to someone else.
Track number one.
Dream of Mickey Mantle. I didn't hear it the first time I listened to the album. I realized that there's some similar background vocals for the I Want to Be Grateful. It's reoccurring in a lot of his stuff, in past album and this album, which I find really interesting.
I found with the first two songs in this album, there are actually a few parts throughout all of the songs where you could kind of hear it leading into a chorus of I Want to Get Better. Like,
oh, yeah,
have you felt that?
I was listening to all of the songs back to back, and it might be because of some of the similar lyrics, but I could hear myself thinking, wait, which song is this? Is this Good Morning, or is this...
Yeah, you find yourself mixing up the songs in the album a lot. But all of the verses, I feel like you could cut and paste them with I Want to Get Better. You could take verse from any one of these songs and just put it in...
Curse my bedroom. I want to get better. The next song on the record is Good Morning.
One thing I have to say about Good Morning was the panning. And later through the album, I found that there were a few spots where the panning in the songs were kind of questionable. Because it kind of just displaced where the sonics should be.
So your final verdict on the panning is... Didn't like it so much.
I liked certain parts, I just thought it was too much.
Because I was actually kind of a big fan of the harsh panning. I thought it was stylistic and just something that could really, you could hear it and think, oh my god, that sounds like the Bleachers.
Made me really happy, and I just keep finding bad things to say about it.
See, it's really interesting.
So I'm contradicted.
And this album made me really happy too, but if you look at all the lyrics, they're all really, really depressing.
And they're all over the place. At the beginning, he's lost, and then he's not lost anymore, and then he's lost again, and then he wishes he was lost. In the lyrics, further down in the album, just his perspectives totally change, and it's basically a concept album without a concept. When I was watching interviews, he said that was intentional, that he wants people to, instead of know exactly what the lyrics meant, to wake up one day and realize it. It felt a little scattered in that sense.
I disagree with you. I love the way it is, and I like the lyrics.
Here's one example. Hate That You Know Me says nothing about any of the specific things that person knows about him. That one and Let's Get Married, a lot of the lyrics are still about him instead of the person that is so overwhelmingly affecting him. Because he's trying to be relatable while he's talking about these girls, but when he's talking about the girls, really in the song, he's kind of talking about himself.
It's funny because now that you say that, all of his music videos in the past end up with some girl either beating him up or him not being with a girl. Hate That You Know Me, with a big smile on my face.
Strangers, acting like I'm a stranger, looking up at me all night.
And you know what? I hate it. Jack Antonoff is just such a good songwriter that all of his songs he can write, every chorus, and make it catchy and stick in your brain and just stay there in your ears, and it makes me so happy.
My one thing with this song, it could have been 20 seconds shorter with one less chorus. From there out, for the rest of the album, it's a lot of therapeutic positivity. Rolling Stone coined it therapy rock, and I kind of agree with that. All of his stuff is just trying to help you out.
This album is very grand.
Absolutely. All of the songwriting is great.
Oh my god, the songwriting's so good!
Who are his heroes? It's still about him!
Mickey Mantle is his hero. There you go. We solved the album in its entirety. Mickey Mantle is on this album because it is
But it's
hero.
Heroes plural. Did Mickey Mantle have a brother?
No, Mickey Mantle's mentioned twice, though.
That's because it's like a half-concept album. All my heroes, Let's Get Married, none of them are about the people that he's writing about. All you're supposed to do with this record is just, like, jam along and feel good about yourself and not think about it.
I don't think so. I think there's a lot of deep lyrics that you can think about.
You're right.
Now you're just contradicting yourself.
I'm in you're such contradiction with this here. Album. I'm going to rate it a 10 and a 1 at the same time.
You're going to be like, it's a negative 1 and an 11.
Yeah! Because it is. Like, it's terrible.
What?
But it's really
it's
good.
Not. It's great!
I think it's... I don't know.
I wouldn't take away any of the songs on this album. Every song on this album has a purpose.
There's a lot of goodbyes, and it's just a whole nostalgia field trip. Its goal is to take you down the road of all of the feels possible. Well, with the overarching bump it happiness. I keep questioning what he's choosing to end with, because he could have ended with goodbye, I miss those days, nothing is you, or I'm ready to move on. Those are all songs he could have
Or start. With. He started with the Mickey Mantle thing, and he could have ended with the Mickey Mantle thing. So there's just so many different variations of how he could have ended it. I just really want to, I'm not saying that he ended it wrong. I just really want to know the reason behind it. Foreign Girls is a good song. I like it. There's that little saxophone part in it that's really, really dope. And
but it's like a Bon Iver ripoff.
Bon Iver. Bon Iver. Bon Iver.
If you listen to 22 A Million, the exact same solo alone saxophone at the end of the album, I swear to God, Bon Iver does 80 million times better.
Bon Iver. Bon Iver. Bon Iver.
It's just, I've had the same sort of contrary back and forth feeling. I love the songs when I think about them individually and uncritically. But then as soon as I start thinking and trying to make sense of them, it just falls off for me.
You could say it's making you bananas.
It's like putting a banana peel on the floor and then shooting fireworks when you slip.
Yay, you slip!
Yay, trouble in life and... bad things happening
Let's
and unsureness.
Tune to it.
That was the Bleachers album for me. Like, just don't think about it and put it on while you're playing volleyball at the beach. If you're the type of person who just likes to listen to music to elevate your mood, then listen to this album.
But then if people listen to it to elevate their feelings, then it's not a very good album because it's also really depressing.
Right. So just question marks all around.
Let's talk about our favorite songs off this album. You tell us your favorite songs in the comments down below, and here are ours.
I'm gonna have to say that my favorite songs are Good Morning and Goodbye. Because honestly, they're the most straightforward and to the point lyrically. They really get their message across, and there's no wishy-washy questionability in how everything makes sense. They're just really finely packaged, really good songs. So I'm gonna say that those are my favorite too.
Honestly, this album is just full of a lot of favorite songs for me. I will be playing this album a lot for the next few weeks. This album is a really great album to me. So I don't have any particular favorites off of it just because I think it's a really good album in its entirety. But one song that really stuck out to me was Good Morning. And I don't know why. It was just this song that really caught my attention after listening to the album. I was like, hey, I want to listen to Good Morning again. Even though all of the singles off this album were absolutely to die for and amazing as well.
Ratings!
For Gone Now by the Bleachers, I'm going to rate this album Millennial Pink.
Millennial Pink?
Millennial Pink.
You can't rate a color?
You know that dusty rosy pink that's kind of Kanye pink, but not quite, because Kanye pink's a lot pinker than Millennial Pink.
Okay, elaborate.
I feel like it really encaptures the idea that this album is bright and chipper and playful, but at the same time it has some darker undertones and it's kind of depressing.
I'll stick traditional. I'll just give it a number rating. My rating changed many times throughout listening to this. The first time, it was really good. I really liked the album. It was like a 7.8. Once I started digging into it a bit deeper, I really started not liking a few of the details in the album and just inconsistencies. So it went down to like a 5.1. But...
what?
Okay, but it went up from there. Listening to Jack's interviews and how he approached the record made me take it a bit less seriously than that second time around listening to it. I'll give it a final score of 6.4.
Tell us what you thought about the album down below. We'd love to hear what you think.
And make sure to subscribe if you want to see more album reviews. Stop.